You have Tourette's, I swear. I swear you have
Tourette's. I think Tourette's. I do. We can't get checked out. We can't do anything without making noise or doing something, man. We're trying to go right into this, and it's not even happening. Oh, my gosh. What a joke.
It's rock and roll.
Yeah. You know?
Duesenberg in Freiburg.
Via enjoyment, Germany.
Oh dear.
I went East Coast.
No, man, we're live all over the world. Next or at the end? Wow. Well, I thought we were gonna do it at the end.
Oh, okay, we can do that, Spider.
Okay. I thought you said we were gonna do it at the end, Spider.
We did. Are we going completely live now? Oh, yeah.
I don't know. Was that live?
I don't know.
I was just rehearsing.
I don't even know if anybody's on here.
Well, not if you didn't click the live button.
Oh, my God. What were we doing just then? We just went crazy. We went rock and roll crazy.
Well, it's our 20th broadcast podcast, SoulCast.
20 times. Oh, look it. There are people on here.
Peoples.
William Beckett is on. Lionel Stinney.
Lionel, what's up,
brother? Lionel, you got to listen through a good stereo or through some headphones, brother. We got some.
Yeah, we can't.
Taking the guitar solos.
We want to make sure that you don't play this podcast on your phone and listen to the weak iPhone 10X or whatever you refer to.
Right, right. So what's going on,
you
guys?
I like to call that the iPhone text, by the way.
iPhone text. How's everybody been doing this whole week?
Yeah, just fine as I could be.
What do you think about number 20? What do you think?
I think it's pretty amazing that we're still alive,
gosh,
after all.
Can you
that.
Believe that, you guys? We're still here.
You know, I remember doing
number one
early PA stuff and getting shocked and knocked
shocked
down
me.
In the garage.
Yeah.
When the ground wasn't right, and to think that we've survived all these years with all this electronics around us, high powered.
Didn't we record once with a microphone just up in the air and one?
We had it was a two-channel reel-to-reel machine.
Who was that? Your dad's,
it was
right?
My dad's. I used to.
Do you still have that?
That's another story for another
podcast.
Oh no, that's for the depressing podcast.
I think Doug, the microphone was closest to his amp, though.
No, actually, we had it hanging. We had one hanging off the rafters and another one laying right on the monitor. For those two channels, and it came out pretty clean.
Now, do we still have that reel-to-reel anywhere?
Yeah, it is. It is at my house someplace.
Really? Yeah. Are you serious?
Yeah. Wasn't that a Triumph song, Lay It on the Monitor?
What was our set list back then? Do you still have a set list?
He ain't even responding to that.
No, he's not gonna do that. What did we play at Radio City when we played that? Let's talk about our heyday.
Okay.
Do you guys remember what we had?
We opened with Lay It on the Line.
I think we opened with Lay It on the Line.
Oh,
yeah.
My God. Triumph. Yeah.
I was wearing white painter's pants.
I remember. I have a picture of that. You sitting on my bar stool in my room.
I'm ashamed that I had the Tom Petty shirt on, though.
That's right. You did.
I think I had. That was all I had clean in the laundry.
Yeah.
You didn't have the Dr. Pepper shirt?
It wasn't. It was in the archives.
No,
already.
You remember he used to wear the Dr. Pepper shirt a lot, right? We have a few pictures of that.
And the painter's pants.
That was a good look, though. Did you wear the red tennies?
I'm sure obviously? The red tennies were on.
Yeah, yeah. We got to check those out.
What
I
size were they?
The 13s are always 13s.
No, not the tennies. The painter's pants.
Oh, no. 34s.
I don't know, man.
Were they Mick Jagger-esque?
No, they were comfortable.
They were. Well, I just want to say that, you know, reminiscing back to our 20th, even though this is just a 20-time podcast we have going, that I really love you two guys. I love playing with you guys. You guys are the best musicians that I know.
Hey, it's
I've
like,
ever played with in my lifetime.
Wow, thank you.
Play with a lot of guys, and I just enjoy playing with you guys. And we have such a good time together. We communicate in such a different level, like, you know, just tonight, you
sure.
know, and a few things. We just look at each other. We know what's going down. It's a pretty amazing thing. You
yeah,
know?
It's tight. It's like a heart and soul shaker, I think, is what we are.
Heart and soul
shaker. But no, I mean, because there's a lot of love, you know, between us. It's a good thing.
Yeah, we still haven't got any recording done, and I apologize for my weekend. I was like, okay,
yeah.
I need a
the
I
guy,
need Charles
the guy who
talk.
Mentioned it in the last
I
podcast.
Know.
Yeah, don't listen to the last podcast all the way through.
Yeah, yeah. And my voice is dead tonight because I ate a brownie at work, and it killed my throat. Thanks, Monty. I was talking to Monty at the time, and I choked up on something he said and just...
Lisa wasn't a Girl Scout cookie.
I told them to call you at lunch, and that's my fault.
What's your favorite Girl Scout cookie? What was your favorite? Like, every year, now they have them like it's a big deal. Now they have ice cream and the whole gig. What was your favorite?
The chocolate mint ones that you put in the freezer.
Oh, okay. You know, mine were the peanut butter, right? Were those yours, Monty?
Yeah, I'm down with the peanut butter.
I really like the shortbread ones, though, or whatever those were, just like a plain cookie.
Right.
Those yeah.
But it's kind of a bummer because every year was fun to get Girl Scout cookies, and now it's no fun because everybody has them. Now Walmart has a whole Girl Scout cookie section.
They actually have the line, really.
Yeah, they've
GSA cookies
duplicated the line, copywritten the line. YouTube would ban them.
I was laughing because last time I bought Girl Scout cookies, Mom and the Girl Scouts come up with the wagon, pulling the wagon out front.
They're like a hit squad, dude.
She comes up and knocks on the door. No, but I was digging it because I don't have to fish for change at the grocery store. They come to the house and knock on the door, and I'm going, oh, this is great. And I go out and got like $40 worth. I kind of emptied the wagon.
Oh no!
How much you got there? What do you got? You know, I'm saying,
yeah,
You know, they're
give me that box.
They're in front of the supermarkets, right?
Yeah.
When you walk in, it's like you're going through a Medellin checkpoint. That they stare you down.
Look
what,
at
what does that
look
mean?
At what does that mean?
Drug cartel checkpoint.
Oh my God!
Where do they have those?
That is so bad.
Where I would have run into one. I don't know these.
Well, do they still?
I'm not familiar
have, I
with
mean,
the reference.
I haven't seen the Girl Scouts out lately. Are they still out? And is there such thing as the Girl Scouts? And I know, is a Boy Scout still around? I mean, am I just totally in the dark?
I don't know,
here?
We'll have to look it up after.
I think it exists.
It does exist.
But I think it's relative. Boys and Girl Scouts these days.
Oh, so Girl Scouts can be boys. Can the boys be in the Girl Scouts?
They Scouts.
I got Scouts. Right on. So what did you guys do all week? Anything? Or, you know what's so weird is the Monday seemed like it came quicker than like when we used to do the Wednesdays? Does that seem weird, or does it seem like we've been away for a bit?
It's probably because you're catching up on your sleep, and then Monday gets here.
I'm not catching up on my sleep. As you can tell, I'm tired. Yeah, it's heavy duty.
We should do a podcast where you take a nap at the drum kit.
That'd be fun.
And Doug and I just do quiet jamming.
But we'll be jamming, and he'll subconsciously in his sleep just be keeping
tapping
the meter,
on my foot. Yeah,
the meter
right on.
Yeah.
Anything happen this week that we have any good stories for Doug Barnes? Doug Barnes always got one good story for us for the podcast.
A good and long one
that we can talk about.
We got domicile expansion going on.
Oh yeah, how
so
did that go?
They dumped a bunch of cement out back, and the guys put it where it's supposed to go.
Right.
And
well, you had the firework house for how long did that go on?
Well, that was probably a week or so waiting on we got the permit, and then the demolition started right away.
Right, right.
And so that was about a week before they came out to put the concrete down.
Yeah, yeah.
And then they said, hey, Monday we're gonna start framing.
Oh no!
And they got that thing. All the walls are up.
Nice.
And
so when do I move in?
That's not.
But bump. I didn't do it.
Anytime.
There's the closet for you.
Just saying.
But we just got to put the trellises up.
Yeah, yeah.
That's what those are.
Well, right on. Right on. Right on. How about you, Monty? How's your joint going? Everybody's got things going.
Yeah,
I'm still in the same joint.
Yeah, we're doing DIY stuff. We're fixing to sand the floors, wood floors down.
Oh, right on.
Stain them and clear coat them.
Do you watch the channel, the DIY channel?
Yeah, we sure do.
Yeah.
We watch it a lot.
You know, one thing that I noticed is they do a remodel and it takes like an hour.
I know.
And they've been like 2 weeks on mine already. And I'm thinking, hey, you know, aren't you guys a little overtime here?
All those remodels, they take 1 hour, and everybody's
exactly.
happy. At
well,
the end
actually,
of
it's probably less because they go to commercial.
Yeah, exactly.
That's
right. Yeah.
They probably eat their lunch.
How do those guys? How do you get those guys over to your house to build for you? Do you have to sign up for something, or they just come into your house and just start digging away? And do you have to pay for that?
Is it just
you being on the show? Okay, that's all you get.
No, I read some stuff. House. It's like when Chip and Joanna get your house all dialed in and it looks
who
real pretty inside.
Chip and Diana?
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
Did I say Diana or Joanna?
I don't know. One of those two.
Okay.
JoJo.
JoJo.
Yeah. Anyway, when they get it all done and she walks around and she's putting all this pretty stuff all around, and you don't get that stuff.
That ain't staying. Yeah. I was corrected on that. I go, oh, man, that's cool. They get all that stuff. And
yeah.
Conan goes, no, they don't get that furniture.
So the camera shuts off and
they take it all back out and you put your own stuff
kidding.
In. Yeah.
Wow.
So then it just looks like the same dump I had, only bigger.
Yo, hello.
Oh.
A little bit of hits tonight. Yeah, a lot of hits.
So they're still dealing with it after they leave.
Yeah.
They're depressed.
Yeah.
Exactly.
What does their house look like?
They still have an empty shell.
Exactly.
They're still an empty shell.
Did you guys see any bands this weekend? Anybody?
I went to a Huntington Beach club.
Oh, what club was that?
Gallagher's.
Oh, where was that at? Huntington Beach Club.
It's on, like, 2nd. or something like that off of Main Street.
Is it a big club or a small club?
I don't know.
Let's compare it to, okay, let's say Bobby V's.
About the same size as Bobby V's. Okay. Only it's...
now you're giving
It's more of a rectangular, and Bobby V's is a little bit wider.
I got you, okay.
What's the transient ratio to the regular customers?
I would say...
5 to 1.
No, 6 to 1.
Six to one.
Yeah.
Six transient.
I didn't see him because I didn't go under the pier.
Yeah. What band
played? Oh.
What?
I had too many hits tonight, man. Is that for your 20th? You're making all the jokes tonight.
No, I'm just.
What band did you rock and roll with?
There was I caught the tail end of. Well, that's kind of a dopey thing to say.
Oh.
Tail end of a Scorpions band.
Now, was it a Scorpions band? Was it all female Scorpions?
No.
Was there a female in the band?
Didn't see any.
Right. Now, were they good? Did he do Klaus Meine?
How did you know if they were female?
I don't know. I got there on the last song.
What did they play? Blackout? Bump, damp, damp, bump. Didn't we do Blackout? Did we do Blackout at Radio City? That's number two.
Did he hear me?
What? No, I didn't.
How did you know they were male or female? Did you look under the stingers?
Oh, no.
You said it's female Scorpions.
Don't answer to him. Where's Carlos when we need him? Hey, where's
Carlos? Where's Silos?
Where's Carlos tonight?
He's puppy sitting.
Oh, he is puppy sitting. What's he doing puppy sitting?
Pups. Some peeps went out of town and got him to go over and hang out with the dog. And
here's the funny thing. Okay, so Carlos is part of the gig, right? Carlos hasn't even chimed in yet.
Can you believe that, dude?
He's busy. He's watching a dog.
He's not even chiming in. I feel so bad.
He's part of the crew.
If I wasn't here, I'd chime in.
Yeah, I know. I would too.
I'd just be going, what are those two guys up to?
I think we did. Yeah, we're checking in with Cheryl. Cheryl says, actually, Girl Scout cookies are my drug of choice.
Oh, there you go.
Ooh. Yeah. With a smiley face, a big smiley face.
OD.
Jeff Taylor says, it's just Scouts co-ed.
Oh, thank you, Jeff.
Yeah, Jeff, thank you for that.
Co-ed.
And Cheryl again says, happy 20th, boyos.
Oh, sure, thanks.
Yeah, thank you very much. And you can shock me. That's what Jeff Taylor said. So that's all we've got so far.
Shock me?
Shock me. I'm not sure what he meant by that.
We were talking about getting shocked, and he's doing Ace
Frehley. Oh, I got you. Yeah, yeah.
Kiss
reference. We never got to what bands played. So you said you Scorpions band and what else? I'm sorry, we went off the cover.
UFO tribute band. They're both tribute bands. So.
Oh, tribute band. How was UFO tribute band?
It was
were they good?
Too hot to handle.
Oh, right on. We've seen them before. Did we do sound for them before?
No.
We've never done sound for them.
I don't believe so.
The lead singer was at one of our shows.
Oh, that's right. She was at Fitzgerald's, I think, when we played there a long time.
We busted into, we ended with Rock Bottom.
Rock Bizzle.
I think she was running up with some kind of contract we had to sign because we're doing
it. Oh, no.
She was going to rat us out if we didn't give her, like, $10.
I know. Exactly. Hey, is it too late? What time is it? It's 9:30.
On the East Coast, we're way into tomorrow.
Oh, man, 9, 10, 11, yeah.
All those clubs that you were going to back in New York, they're already a.m. over there, brother.
Oh, no. What are we doing here so late? Monty, don't you have to work tomorrow?
We do
whatever it takes, man.
Do you have to work in the morning early?
Yeah, tomorrow's my Monday.
Oh, no. Sorry about that, buddy.
Well, no,
we thought,
you know, people would be chiming in later.
Yeah.
Because last week, Carlos said, hey, man, there's people jumping on 5 minutes before we cut off.
Yeah, yeah. I don't know how many people are on us right now, but we did pretty good. I mean, it's just, you know, everybody's kind of up late, maybe.
Well, it helps if we
if
we replay this bad boy on Wednesday at the proper time.
Yeah, we've got quite a bit of people on here. We've got a few people chiming in. Well, right on. Do you guys want to call it early? We already did... 8 songs. Do you want to do one more song and then call it?
How long we've been
call
on?
It a night?
Because you know,
what time do we start?
I think about 8:30.
Did we really?
I don't know.
How long does it say we've been on for? Does it even tell us that?
But I'm thinking that
8 hours.
If we stop early, then people will be getting on just as we're going off.
Of course, so. And then they can just chime in later and see what we're doing. We're just going crazy on our
20th. How about for our 25th one? How about we do a 25-hour podcast?
Oh, yeah, we'll just keep repeating
it. That'd be great.
Yeah, Monty can spend the night here.
But not in a row. We'll just do like 25 one-hour segments.
One-hour segments all the way through.
As long as we invite John Mellencamp.
Oh, no.
I saw an interview with him today. Kind of interesting. Sammy's Rock and Roll Roadshow.
Yeah.
He interviewed Mellencamp. He said he never liked the notoriety, the public figure thing, you know, the fame.
So he wasn't
whatever fame or fortune.
Was that in the '80s? Yeah.
Yeah, he said he goes. He bought into it for a little while, but then about a couple years in, he's like, I don't even like this. He doesn't like playing live.
No kidding.
You know, he goes, I know we got to do it because we all, you know, when we make an album and it's in a pop. It's
that's
a
okay. I don't like buying his album, so we're even.
No, but he's a real like real deep guy. He paints. He's actually a really great painter, but he paints, and he just said he wanted always wanted just to be his own guy. He didn't want to be a monkey on a string,
right?
For the the record companies or whatever. For
now
the business,
right? Does he still play to this day?
Yeah, he's Access showed a concert that he did recently.
Oh, okay. I know he had a heart attack. The Farm Aid stage, and he was a mess for a while because he smokes like a
He still smokes. When Sammy was interviewing me. Mm-hmm. Lit one up.
Oh, no kidding.
Guy's still smoking, but I don't know. I think Meg Ryan's with him now.
Oh, is that?
I think she's.
Are you serious?
I think he's actually upset because she got more injections in her lips.
Oh, my gosh. Here we go. Yeah.
And he's, now he doesn't like it.
Did you guys ever listen to. I know your answer.
You just switched channels on me.
Yeah.
Television channels.
I did. I had to switch.
You're
out
lucky
on
the
Meg
test
Ryan
pattern didn't just show up.
I know.
You.
I was about ready to just. Hey, Todd Peterson just joined.
Todd, we waited for you, brother.
Todd Peterson.
Hey, can you put the test pattern up just over Monty?
I love that guy.
I know. Did you guys ever listen to John Mellencamp? Did you ever like his music? And what is his music? Is it rock and roll? Is it like Bruce Springsteen style stuff? What is it?
It's Heartland roots rock.
I gotcha. I just remember that.
Can you explain that? What that
Jack
means?
And Diane song. What else did he have? Was he born in the USA or
born
is that
in the USA? No, rocking in the USA.
Rocking
in the USA. R O C K in the USA.
That's right. Do you always got to have one of those songs if you're Bruce Springsteen like? Because we had Born in the USA by Bruce Springsteen.
I don't know. What was
Rocking in the USA?
What would Soul Shaker song be?
I don't know. We wouldn't be rocking.
Yeah, we'd be good rocking.
Good rocking. There we go. Right
what
on.
What a great segue.
Nice segue, Doug.
I still want to know what did you mean by roots? The
heartland music, middle of the country, farmers.
Back up.
You know.
I went back up.
From the dirt, from the potato patch.
But is it different from rock and roll, just like mainstream rock and roll?
Yeah.
I think it's more the message.
Oh, okay.
It's more the lyric. Sentiment. I think he just plays three-chord rock, the genre.
He plays harmonica or does he play guitar as well? Did he play guitar?
Oh, yeah,
guitar.
He plays a tele acoustic. And
oh, he does. All right.
I think he's got a harmonica player.
Right. Yeah, I don't think I've ever gone to, let's go to a John Mellencamp concert. Never have been into that.
What's the roots part of that? The heartland and the heartland?
The blues influenced from early America.
Okay.
Okay, so what got do you it? Call, like, last week we played ZZ Top. What are they Southern rock? Is that what they call that? But what happened on the Sharp Dressed Man deal?
They got commercial.
Yeah. Wow. They went crazy on that.
Same drum beat on that whole album.
But it's the producer. It's not even Frank Beard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's their biggest seller, right? The commercial crud.
I hope so.
It's like Def Leppard. You know, they've been fighting to get that album back ever since they did.
They've been trying to regain that.
They've been trying to get a hold of what's his name? The guy who produced it.
Mutt
Lang.
Which one, Pyromania, you're talking about?
Was that the one? Yeah, was that the Big Daddy? Was that the one with Pour Some Sugar on Me? And what was that other one?
No, I think, wasn't that the next one? Pyromania was like Photograph.
Hysteria. That was the money shot. Yeah.
Okay.
That was a good one. But yeah, they've been trying if every single album, and I don't think they've really done. They did a stay in Vegas, and I saw it online, and their new stuff is not good. They're trying to.
You don't like it.
Well, they're trying to match that.
They're trying to get back to the,
Yeah, and it's just not working.
Radio friendly.
Yeah.
There was an album that I ran into within the past week, Ace Frehley did, called Origin.
Great album.
Volume 1. And he does covers of origin of, rock music or whatever.
Yeah.
So he does, about 8 or 10 songs on that and has different guests. Guys come in and sing.
Did you listen to the whole thing after you and I?
Yeah,
I did. It's good.
Yeah, it's pretty decent. I mean, he's got great artists helping him out with it.
Yeah.
They did that with Montrose as well. He was going to do 10 songs with 10 singers. I don't know if we talked about this before, but it's called 10 by 10.
I think we mentioned it once.
And Ronnie Montrose had played did all of the rhythm guitar stuff on it. And then passed away. And so the bass player and the drummer, I believe, finished it off and invited different singers in that maybe he was already talking about having come in.
Now, is that great out on Spotify?
It's on Spotify,
or somewhere?
Yeah.
Okay, great. I'll listen to that tonight.
Yeah, you were playing that at Bobby V's one night. We did sound.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they just do all Montrose stuff. I Got the Fire, blah, blah, blah.
New stuff.
No, it's all new songs.
Oh, new that, stuff.
Yeah,
he
was doing for that particular album.
And it's legit?
It's a Montrose album.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
But he's got different singers.
Right on.
And different guitar players, yeah.
Right, right. Now, the Ace Frehley thing was quite a surprise because they had Paul Stanley on there. You and I had listened to that one song, Fire and Ice. And who was that? Was that Bachman Turner Overdrive, or who was that?
Free.
Is that Free? Great was song. It, great it, version
was
of that
it
song.
Fire and Water?
What did I say? Fire and Ice?
Yeah.
That was Pat Benatar.
That's one of my favorites.
Yeah, they didn't do that one, so you'll be disappointed.
I'll be disappointed. I'll turn the page on that one. Right on. So you guys want to play one more song and then get out of town for the night? Because Monty's got to go to bed.
Yeah.
Right on. Well, thank you guys for chiming in. I know there wasn't many of you, but maybe you'll look at it later and say, hey, those guys were playing music instead of talking.
Yeah.
We should have been on there.
So we did the music first so that if you don't like the talking, you can just shut it off.
Shut
when the music
it off.
Drops.
Yeah,
but surprise, we're about to play another one, so you do have to listen through all the talking to get to the music.
Okay, there you go. So play.
Good night.
No, that was good. It was single hit.
Let's do a double hit real quick. One, two, three. That's what we wanted. And good night, ladies and gentlemen. We are Soul Shaker.
Make sure to subscribe. Make sure to like. Make sure to share.
Yeah, we are on YouTube. Go subscribe. We got 5 new subscribers this week, by the way. Nice. Thank you very much.
I want to make sure that we can say that everybody that watches this podcast shares well with others. So everybody hit that share button.
Yeah, share it with everybody. Go like our Soul Shaker page at Soul Shaker City on Facebook. Am I correct? I don't even know.
I don't know. Carlos was not with us tonight.
Yeah, yeah.
And I know that a lot of you are upset and maybe turned off right after you turned on.
We also have a Venmo page. You guys can donate to the old Soul Shaker surprise over here. And donations are always great for us. A
not
couple
really,
buck here.
Not really donations. It's more like a subscription. A
subscription. There you go.
Because we're not a 501c3.
We're working on that. Anyways, you guys, we love you so much. Thank you for showing to our number 20. Number 21, you guys.
That's two X's,
my
man.
Gosh. Is that what it is? That's two X's? 10?
I've only got one X, but that's two X's. More, yes.
Oh,
yeah, you got one, too?
You got one, too. Okay,
so
you guys.
That's what I'm saying. We got two X's.
We love you so much. See you on the next broadcast. We don't know when that's going to be.
Good night.
Next week sometime.
Somebody call the cops and let us out of Helmut's dungeon.
Good night from Freiburg, Germany, because we're all over the world.
Adios, muchachos.